Hey guys, welcome back. It's been a little while since I recorded one of these episodes, but we're back here and got a little bit of changes in the map. Had a great demand of canola just earlier in this game day and made quite a bit of money, probably over about 250,000, which was really nice. Bought some good equipment. Well, probably not too much, I don't think. Ended up getting finally a front loader. As you can tell, I got all this equipment here. let's see where it's at. All the mods. As you can tell, I got some forestry stuff. With this map, I'm not feeling the forestry too much because I could probably go ahead and get a field and place some trees down, but I kind of like doing forestry in the woods, like going out in the woods and getting some trees, but there's no real forest area in this map and it kind of sucks, so kind of a little iffy about forestry right now on this map. I've been cutting trees down along some of the fields, but we'll come back to that later. Got a water tank because I thought there was the water mod. I should have known better. I don't think there was. But I could use that later on for other stuff like greenhouses. Got some cows finally. About 4 cows, 4 sheep. And let's keep going on the mods. Oh, got the chicken coop mod. Found that the other day. It's one of my favorite mods. I'm glad they finally ported this over because I hate trying to find those eggs. They're all over the place. And in this map, there's some that I haven't even found. And I'm wondering if they're actually in the tree, so. Got that John Deere front loader. Really nice. The same guys that did this, MB3D, came out with these disc weights for the John Deere and other tractors. It's really nice. This weight pack's really awesome, so I'm loving that. I'm loving this John Deere. I think this is actually the first time I got to really use it in a map without testing. It's really nice. I love it. So yeah, here's a chicken coop. The old chicken coop mod. I love it. It's pretty nice. You just go in there and your eggs will be all lined up in there for you. So definitely something that is needed in the game. If you haven't got it, go ahead, try to look for it. I got about 47,000 left over since all my purchases. Kind of wish they had kind of waiting for the pallet, the placeable pallet mod. I know they have it now where you can implement it in the map, but there was a version where you can actually place it in your map, and that would be awesome. It's that that's the one where it stacks up over time, and then it just, when it gets full, it just pushes along and it keeps stacking up again. So I wish that mod would come out. Maybe it's out. I really don't know. I'll have to go look for it. Oh, my John Deere's gone. I have my John Deere over here. And I honestly don't know why this got so dirty, because I just bought that. I've been noticing John's been acting a little weird with the dirt. Some of this stuff when you come back from a save is really dirty for some reason. Maybe it's just this mod. I don't know, some of the mods, but I did notice that with some of the stuff. Yeah, I got done seeding. Now I'm just spraying this field down. Getting it ready. This I did again in corn. I should have plowed it and put corn down, but I didn't want to do it because I'm doing a plowing a lot. But that's probably what they would normally do, is plow it. So the other field, I believe I got canola again. Let me double check because I don't remember. yeah. This field right here, next time I'm probably going to switch it out and get rid of corn and put something else here. Hopefully another little great demand comes. Probably not going to make that much because the canola great demand is the best one, and that's the one I had. What else? Just added some mods and testing them out. I don't think I have any new harvesters, just the dudes far. I got this little guy. So if, Species 7 had that on his YouTube. He said that's a pretty good mower, so I decided to try it out, test it. Runs pretty well. Finally found a okay in-game stock milk water trailer. This one's actually better than the other one because he made one that he used the stock Garant one. I didn't really like that one too much. I like this one when he redid it. It's pretty nice. When you dump the water, the little nozzle, you have to bring the nozzle down. I'll show you guys that probably in another episode or another Let's Play. finally found the conveyors, a good conveyors. So this does pretty much everything. Decided to do that because that's probably another necessary mod to have. Especially when you get like alternative tipping. Which they kind of have that now. It's called placeable heaps. I haven't tried that yet. I'm kind of waiting a little bit. I kind of like the idea of alternative heap tipping because you can tip anywhere. I guess the heaps, you can just buy them and place them. But we'll see. I'll mess around with it later and see if I like it. Found another Fortuna. I guess I missed that one. It's the fifth wheel guy, so put him in there. They're about the same price, but little options. And just found this tractor today. It's made by Ego. He's done a lot of the ones from FS13. It's in beta right now, but it runs pretty nice. This is probably one of the other good John Deere's we have right now besides the 6810, one of the bigger ones. Gets dirty. Gets really dirty, as you can tell right there. It runs pretty well. I don't have no problems with it. So, and he recommends that you have drive control mod in, which I already have, so it's not a big deal. So that's about probably it with mods, maybe. I don't know if I showed you guys this one. This is a John Deere air seeder. It's pretty much kind of the one in game, but it's a little bit bigger. I thought it was original design. I got excited about it, but I kind of left it in here. It's pretty nice. Yeah, just these weight guys right here. That's about it. Oh, then I got, yeah, it's been a while since I showed you guys. Got some stuff from Giants. They finally released their placeable seeds and fuel tank and fertilizer tanks. That's another bunch of mods that I really like. So, yeah, I don't think there is any more to show you guys. Kind of enjoy showing you guys some of the stuff I get, keep you updated. Because I know people get curious about their mods and want to know. Oh, then this one right here. I kind of had this one. It was a modded one. It was ported over from FS13. But I guess Giants released this for people that got the game. What was it? Steam, I believe? I don't remember, recall. But yeah, this one is actually better than the modded one. It's a little bit cleaner looking. It looks a little bit nicer than the modded one. And it actually functions properly when you do course play. Like when you do the, it's called the automatically figure out how wide your implement is or whatever. It'll detect it. Because the other one never detected it, so I had to manually put it in. But yeah, it works pretty fine. Definitely replace it with Giants because Giant stuff is always better and cleaner. So yeah, that's about it, I think. Definitely found a map that I'm going to play on, another map. It's called, well, initially the one I saw was My Little Country. It's made by the same mod author. Well, I don't know if it's made by him. He has like a team of guys, but I know he has a website. Marhi, or however you say that. He has a website you can go on, and he has a bunch of mods on there. And either him or the guys he works with created this map called My Little Country, and it's a really nice little map. It's about medium size. I say it's larger than Brookridge, but it's a European map, but it looks really nice. And then he came out with one a couple days later where he expanded the outside area and put some giant fields in, called it My Big Country. And I'm probably going to be playing My Big Country just because I have the option of doing really large equipment when I expand around the edge of the map. And then towards the center, when I start out, I can do a little equipment. So it's really nice. And when he did the, let me see if he's still got a little ways. When they did the, Big Country expansion, with those extra fields, and he put some nice forest areas in there, and I really like them, so I'm probably going to do a let's play on that one because I need and love to do some nice forestry maps, and this one doesn't really have anything. And I know they have a Westbridge Forest mod, but I've kind of already started this one and kind of like this one, but I think this map's more for farming. So it goes back to the old school FS13 of just farming. It's really nice though. As far as forestry, I don't think I'm gonna get too serious in it. I'll still keep the equipment and just store it. Because this is the only spot I found pretty good trees that I wanted. And I don't like these trees here that much anyways, because it gives room for these tractors with large implements to turn around. Sometimes those trees are a little problematic. I don't know. I can always replant them later. I just wanted to test out forestry in this map, and honestly, I don't really like it in here. I like I said, I like the atmosphere of doing it in a dense forest, you know. But I could probably, like I said, grow them in one of these small fields, maybe like 18, but I might do that later on. That's actually a pretty decent size small field, is 18. Or actually 5 over there and 6 I could plant. Yeah. I could probably turn like 6 into grass and then plant the trees so it looks like a little forest area. Yeah, there's always options. Definitely need some forest, a decent forest area in this map. So I just left these logs here. I'm probably not going to cut them down. I'm just going to drag them over there because I'm not really feeling forestry right now on this map, like I said. So I just want to drag those over and get it over with. Just want to get back into farming. Oops. Yeah, it's a nice little tractor. I love this tractor. Let's turn the hood off. I gotta fill that guy up actually. That's why I had that truck out there. And it's perfect timing. Hopefully you guys are doing good. It's Christmas Eve while I'm recording this, but it's not in the eve time. It's about 2 p.m. Eastern time, my time. Some of you guys are probably in other countries. You guys probably already is Christmas Eve. It's probably almost Christmas for you guys. not doing much for Christmas Eve. My wife and I do stuff during Christmas. We drive down and go see the in-laws, her family down in Pennsylvania. And then we come back up in the evening. So it's pretty nice. Hopefully, I guess she ordered me a new mouse, and I have an assumption she ordered me a keyboard because she was going to get me the IT Runner Pack for Christmas, but she said she's not getting that because I think she got me something else, and I assume she got me a new keyboard. But she's been checking it out, says it hasn't delivered yet, so probably won't get it. Whoops. This guy probably won't get it on Christmas. All right, let's go drag this over. You know me, I like to play a little realistic, but as you can tell, I'm not doing too realistic with the forester right now. I'm just not feeling it, like I said. Buren Home map. Oh yeah, definitely. I love the forestry in that one. But we'll definitely get to do it in my big country. I'll probably do an intro video of that later, just to drive around so you guys can see the map if you guys haven't seen it. I'll just do the large map and tell you which parts used to be the small one. There's another map that I like. It's Alps 15. That came out a few days ago and I tried it out, but there's some problems with the map. But yeah, he just updated it today and fixed the problems. I guess some of the sell points weren't working. That map, I don't think I'm gonna do a series on it. If I do it, it'll be like a four-part mini-series because that map is very mountainous and hilly. And I don't know if... I know in real life there's farms like that, but I don't know if the Giant's physics engine and some of the way the Giant's game works will actually function well, because I could see some of those combines on the hills slipping down. But we'll try it out. The only thing, other thing that I noticed, I don't know if he did that or if there's a sell point for the fields. I couldn't find any sell points on the fields themselves, so I don't know if he has like a building where you go buy everything. But I really don't have that problem because I have the mod where I can buy fields from wherever. But as for other players, they might have a problem. But it's a very beautiful map, though. It's very scenic. Let's see if this works. I've never been down here. Oh, I should have kept an eye on how much I made. Was that about 10,000, I think? We'll see with the next one. Oh, is that fertilizer guy done yet? Oh, as you can tell, I took fast switcher off for the meantime because there's just a lot of buttons right now that use control and just gets in the way right now. It's a lovely mod. I'll save it for when there's tons of equipment. I still have the bad habit of tabbing. And now that 15 has the shift tab, you can go back. So I still just tab. It doesn't matter. Yeah, this 6810 sounds really nice. It purrs, man. And I put the, when I got those front weights, I put them on. I think I got those weights yesterday or the day before, and I put them on. It looks really nice on here. Those weights actually work on the New Holland, because you know the New Holland doesn't have any like attachment weights. It'll actually fit in there. So awesome weight mod. Glad he came out with this. Those guys are doing great jobs. I'm gonna have to get a shout out right now for all the modders. You know, all you guys do a really great job in making us mods. Thank you guys. Awesome job to all the modders. Kind of got in a debate the other day in the Giants forum, actually yesterday, because I don't have the trailer in my mod pack right now, but I think you remember it. It's a really long water trailer somebody got made original. I've been trying to convert it to a milk trailer and been having problems with it. So I went on the forums to post if anybody can help me with it or give me some ideas on how to do it. And no one got back to me. And I went on again to like bump up the thread. And someone got on there with a smart remark just saying like, you know, respect the modders' wishes not to edit it or keep the original download link. Which I understand, you know, I understand why, because there isn't a single website where you can actually find the mods. I mean, there's like, what, over a dozen sites where you can find mods, and a lot of these guys, when they work hard on these mods and make a mod, someone comes out with like a version 1.1 and it just keeps going to like 1.3 and they do like small changes and then they try to get credit for it. I understand that, but that's not what I was trying to do on there. I was just trying to go on there and figure out if somebody can help me do that. And he pointed it out, like, you're not supposed to edit that. Respect everybody's thing. You're not supposed to edit it. And I'm just like, okay, I understand your point, but my point is, everybody who gets a mod and puts it in their game has edited it. It's not disrespect out of the modders. It's just because 80% of the mods out there right now, and even in FS13 when it came out, there's a lot of shitty mods out there. And I'm sorry, but we have to edit some of the mods. Who hasn't changed a bucket size capacity or added in more capacity for a tipper, you know? Personally, I edit a lot of my mods because right now there's just shitty mods and there are a lot of reskins and stuff like that. But most of the time when I edit the mods, they're usually because I can't read German or another language and I would like to have a description that I understand, you know? So it's not like I do that and then repost them on the download site and say, hey, I did this, give me credit for it. So no disrespect to your modders, but you guys do a great job, and some of you guys do really great jobs on the mods, and some of you guys just get your mods chopped up and they get re-uploaded, and some of you guys just can't do all the work on the mods. I mean, some of you guys are modelers and some of you guys don't know the code, and you guys go in there and the tractor doesn't work right, or we just tweak them a little bit and make them work for our game. That's the whole reason why I tweak the stuff, just for my game. That's the whole reason why I wanted to tweak that milk, that water tray, that milk, just for my game. I really don't care if anybody else gets it. I'm not going to re-upload it, so. So I gotta have to say my piece about that. It kind of upset me a little bit. But overall, yeah, modders do an awesome job. And I feel bad for them too, because some of these people upload and it says don't, they always put don't upload on unless it's original site, but I could see four or five of those like from one mod on four or five different sites that says don't upload an original site because some guy just said, hey, I want to upload this and change it and put it on our site. The modders are really awesome. The modding community kind of really sucks for that, especially in Farm Sim. People just come along and just chop up mods or add things to it and just mess it up. You know, they get in the scripts and stuff and mess things up. And the community is really bad. There's no universal place to go. Because I play Kerbal Space Program. I've been playing that for years. Well, a couple years. Probably since 0.12, which is way back when. And their community is universal. There's one place you go. There's their forums, and that's where you get their mods. They may upload them on some other site, but it always links you to the forums. And the thing about that is you can get in contact with the modders. You can contact them through private message. You can contact them through the forum thread. So it's easy to contact those guys. And you can put in suggestions. But here, you know, it's really hard. The community is really, there's virtually no way to communicate to a modder author and say, hey, can you possibly add this in? It would be awesome. And we wouldn't have to do that, you know, have to change it ourselves and figure it out. And possibly break it. Oh, excuse me. But Kerbal Space Program, the forums, the mods are getting kind of bad now. It's not because of the modders themselves. It's the same modders, so it's a decent-sized community. But they're starting to do like in Farm Sim. They're not respecting the modders. And there was an incident with one of the mod authors. He didn't want to implement a certain thing in his mod, and one guy got pissed off without his permission, added that in and re-uploaded it like it was the original one and without the respect of the mod author. And the mod author got pissed, and they had this whole big argument on the forums about it. This was probably over the summer. And the mod author just got pissed off and just kind of took it too personal and ended up leaving the community and kind of put that mod on pause. So it was really sad. We've never had that before in the past with the community over there. I think it's just a lot more players are coming in the game over there. There's a lot of players over there. Yeah, it's just getting ridiculous. But it's still a nice place to get mods and contact the authors. And no one's going to come along and do a 1.2 version of your thing and just add one little thing in the line, an XML line, and say, hey, give me credit for it. So that's all I have to say about that, you know. I've done some modding over there. I helped out the modders a lot in KSP. Some of the guys that I think need help, and they're smaller guys, and that if it's a mod that I really love, I'll definitely help them out. And I understand the coding a little bit more over there. The XMLs here, I have no idea how this stuff works. So that's why I go on the forums and ask questions, but people think I'm going to steal things or re-upload them. It's not my intention, guys. I've done some modding in Silent Hunter 5. I don't know if any of you guys played that, but when that game came out, that game, they released it halfway done, so the modders needed to come along and fix the game. And you definitely have to have about like 30 mods to actually get the game to run properly. But the thing there with the mods, the way it works, there's no universal way. So you have another mod that's going to override another mod, so there's a certain order you have to like load the mods in, because if you load them the wrong way, sequential order, one mod will break the other, and that's a big thing that's going on there. So a lot of times you got to help out those guys to figure out the proper order to make things work. And once somebody has a proper order, you kind of like take a screenshot or tell the guys what order it is. But the community there is really nice. The modders, if you come along and help them or have your own, they're just grateful. And they don't care if you take over. Sometimes they don't even care if you give credit, but if you do get credit, it's always welcome. It's just because the game's so broken that they, oh, I missed a spot here. Or is that just coming up really quick? I think that's coming up. That they're just grateful that get the game working properly. I don't blame them. Let's see if this part's planted. Seems to be. There would be a line there, I think. If there's not, we'll see. So I did a mod on there. It's accurate ammo. Because I'm big with numbers. If something's not right with numbers, it really bothers me. And that's why I tend to change some of the... I don't get too obsessive with the prices in the game. I could with Farm Sim. But if there's something that's off, I'll definitely change it. And that's, you know, I'm editing it. I'm not hurting. I'm not trying to go against the mod author or anything. I'm just trying to fix it in my game. And I do that with these semis. Because these were originally 69 and 89K. To make it simple for me, I'll just add a digit in the front, and there's 169. And like, I'll add a digit in the front of the maintenance. Instead of 20, it's 120. So it kind of works in game a little bit. These mans too, they were like really cheap. I assume you can get them that cheap in real life, but you can also get them this expensive in real life. But I almost added another digit. Instead of one, I was going to add two. Make that 29.6 and make this one 32.8. But that was way too expensive for these mans. And the reason why I was doing that is because of stock man. And I think that's really too much for a man truck. And this kind of bothers me. I think I might go in and actually put a 185,000. But like, you see what I'm talking about. The prices, some of them will be off. Oops, get back here. Runaway tractor. That's what happens when you talk. So that's what I would did in Silent Hunter. Made an accurate ammo count for like AA guns and deck guns. Because the game didn't actually do it when they came out, and I got accurate numbers from historical books, because I do read. I used to read a lot about World War II stuff, and I'm really into that. And at the time when I was playing the game, I got really obsessive over U-boats, and so those numbers really were bothering me. So. So yeah, talking about everything right now, but hey, it's my channel and sometimes farming makes farming a little bit better when you're chatting it up. It's kind of like one of those monotonous jobs where you have a buddy you can talk to and makes time go by really fast. And it's pretty full. I'll just put this guy back. Where did I have him before? Maybe there. I'll just put him in the shed, I guess. I think I had him in this little covered area. I think I'm going to get rid of this Ursus tractor. I like it, but it's a little underpowered for me right now. So when I get another cash thing coming in, like a great demand, I'm probably going to... excuse me. Got like the hiccups. I want to get my case. What is he? 203 horsepower. This guy is 148. He's not cutting out for me. Because I got these guys, and they're definitely... I don't want to get another one of these. I want to start going into the American stuff. So I'm going to get this guy. Little case guy. I almost bought another one of those John Deere's, and I probably will buy another one of these John Deere's. So the regular one. I really like those a lot. And then I got this. Probably buy this guy later on too. So we'll start getting more on the American side. Because this guy's having a little problems doing some of my seeding and cultivating. He's a little slow. So those fields are down. Let me say that really quick. Yep. I think, where are we? I'm going to turn around here. Okay. Let's bring this back. Yeah, another thing I was doing with editing some of the mods, I found some of them had a couple errors, so I went in and fixed them. Just description errors. So. We edit mods, that's what we do when we love these mods and play them. We want the game to run better, so we, if there's any errors, we try to fix them. I don't upload them. I just fix them for my game. I do have a Google Drive that I upload all my mods on, and that's just for if somebody wants to play with me, they can actually download those and play in a map with me. So if any of you guys want to help me out in one of my farms one of these days, I can definitely give you a link to my mods, and you can come here and help me do some of this work. So definitely can always use help once these farms get bigger. So let's go. Is this guy on? Oh, there's something on. Oh, I was gonna move him. So I'll probably get the IT runner pack after Christmas, when I get some Christmas money. Probably gonna pick up some games off Steam, hopefully. I have enough. Kind of debating about that IT runner pack. I don't know if I would actually use it. I know the function's pretty cool and all, but we almost kind of have those trailers that go on the back of it in the game. You guys won't normally see me log like this. I don't do it like this. I normally do it, cut them up, put them in there. I'm just clearing these out just so I can get back to farming on this map and not logging. I'll probably do it later on, like I said, when I get some of those one of those fields planted. But right now, just gonna keep the equipment on hand. So I want to see how much one of these sells. I wasn't paying attention. Got like 55,000 right now. Oh, did I leave that cedar on? No, it says, okay, whatever. I wish this action had like a timer or something in some sort of overlay so I can know how long my videos are going. I think another feature I wish Morales Action had was a way to render like a list of your videos. Instead of doing it, I have to click on them one by one. I can just load them in a list and then just run through there so I can do it overnight. So right now you have to like load one video, render it out, and when it's done you gotta click this OK button and then open up the other one and re-render it. And the audio issues are really weird. Sometimes I don't get them and sometimes I do. I don't know what the problem is. So I know I was reviewing one of my videos the other night and they didn't have any audio issues. I don't know. I didn't do any changes in the settings. It's just Action just wants to act up sometimes. Okay, 55,000. And the thing about this Westbridge Mac remix, the this wood area selling point doesn't show up on the map. But I knew where it was because I toured around the vanilla Westbridge map and knew it was here. That's a little decent chunk of change. Buy some small stuff, like, what do I need? What do I need that's small? Do you want one of these loading wagons? Oh, it's on 5% sale. Which, why doesn't it tell me the original price like in 13? I want to get one of these to feed my animals. But I'm not going to have any crop this time. It's going to give me hay or straw. I could do mower, get grass actually, but I still need a pickup. Oh, excuse me. Oh, I still gotta add in that script mod from Farming Simulator's official site beta, where you can actually bale grass. I'm gonna add that in because I want to store some bales of grass. So I keep forgetting to add that in. One of these days I gotta get that my big country map set up for us so I can record, buy the equipment. I'll probably do about 800, 900,000 give myself and then buy the equipment, because that they don't give you a lot of equipment in that map. They only give you like two tractors and one combine, and I think they give you a few implements, but it's about it. And I always like to give myself money. Not too much. It just helps me get equipment, because if I don't, it's going to be struggling a lot in the beginning, especially when you're recording and when you're by yourself. We'll just assume I sold one of my maps, probably like Beer Home. My beer on home farm, I sold that one. Yeah, it's surprising that actually that my big country runs great, but Two Rivers Maps doesn't. All right, guys. I'm probably gonna end this episode just to keep time down on this video, and I'll just start one right back up and continue on the next episode. It'd be just pretty much continuing off what we're doing right now. Maybe I'll speed up time and we'll harvest some of this stuff in the field. So, all right, guys. Have a great holiday, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye.